still hasn't answered your question. She didn't answer it in the last debate as well. And that's part of the problem. She's so tied in with President Obama and his failed policies on this issue. The question was, would you agree with the president to send ground troops or not? Bottom line is, you've already taken it off the table. You've taken the greatest fighting force off the table. And we have an opportunity. There's no one talking, by the way, about occupying forces. We're talking about a transitional force, as we've done in other countries. They're not occupiers. We were there to assist the government, the Iraqi government, to make sure that what happened wouldn't happen. And it's that type of lack of leadership.
Well, we're there assisting the Iraqi government.
Where our allies don't trust us. Right
and,
now.
And we're assisting the Kurds
Senator, with respect, the Kurds are hanging on for dear life. They're in trouble. The Iraqi government is in trouble. ISIS is the size of New England right now. And you and the president have taken ground troops off the table, which is the worst thing you can do. When you have the greatest fighting force in the world, you take them off the table. And that's part of the problem. You're so supportive of this president, you can't even say, if General Dempsey and others say we need ground troops, you won't even say right now that, yes, we have to do it. Their goal is to put a flag in the White House. Our goal is to make sure it doesn't happen. And right now, because of the, and as you know, if you don't believe me, Secretary Panetta said he advocated for it, and the president rejected each and every opportunity to make sure we could have a transition force there. It was a mistake. But not for that effort, we would not be in this position.